no other reason that I've been working with Robert Keeley and Andy Timmons to a certain degree in the past year with the launch of this amazing delay, which they call the Halo, which is also now available as the Aurora algorithm and the multi-tap delay algorithm, multi-tap delay algorithm in the XFX. I just thought it might be fun to see if I can recreate a rig that is similar to Mr. Timmons' own, which is based on his dual or stereo Lonestar setup and the things that he uses on his pedal board. So I did a quick bit of research, and I've had to make a couple of compromises here because essential things like the Blues driver, and specifically the Keeley Blues driver, are not available as an algorithm in the XFX firmware as yet. But I was able to park pretty close to it with a three-knob tube driver. The amps are available, the Texas Star Clean, also known as the Lone Star in the real world, and the Texas Star Lead. So I've got both channels of those, and I've dialed up settings that are close to the settings that I see in various illustrations available on the interweb. And the multi-delay, of course, the Halo, I've put in two channels of the Halo here, one of the standard Aurora delay, that's what it's called in the firmware, and another of which is my version with slightly tweaked EQ. More about that in a minute. It's an 8-scene preset, and it runs through different variations with different drives of the both clean and the lead channels, and then there's a chorus thing up the end as well. So this guitar is a Q547 Ibanez with sort of low to medium output, really nice clear pickups. It's a 7-string guitar, as you can see. Hasn't got a headstock, but it's got tuners down here, so that's thoughtful, and it just sounds great. It lets me split the coils here, which is a handy thing. And I'm using it because Andy uses an Ibanez and I don't have one of his guitars, but this is what I do have. So here it is. Let's go. Scene number one, the compressor, straight up. I know he uses a Carl Martin compressor, probably with his own name on it, and he uses it with two different channels, one with compression wound up around here. And one with the compression wound back and the level sort of cranked a little bit so it's more of a boost. Now I've written a little thing into the scene switch which lets you switch between those compression channels. It's a preset override switch, it'll be on your preset. One and channel B. If you turn it off, that channel is not as lively. Scene two, I keep getting mixed up with scenes and channels. Scene two introduces the drive, and the first drive is the tube drive, or the three-knob tube drive, acting as a kind of faux blues driver. Once again, there is a special per preset override switch written into that scene button, which lets you flick through the channels of the drive block. And as you can see, channel A is that three knob tube driver. If I hold it, it will flick to a cranked tube driver where the level is really cranked and the driver is backed off and the tone is backed off. This is from a picture I saw on Andy's board. I don't know whether he uses it with the clean channel of his amp or the dirty channel, but it's different. Channel 3 of the drive block is a crunch box. Why a crunch box? Because an Angry Charlie is modelled on the crunch box. The J JHS-AT distortion is modelled on the Angry Charlie, if I'm not mistaken. You guys can, I'm sure, will correct me if I am. So I figured, well, we'll just go back to roots. We'll just pop a crunch box in. I mean, that's what they're all trying to be, right? So it's a... And then the fourth channel of that drive block is the BB, the ATBB, which has got a lot more headroom. I love that. And then if you cycle back through it, it'll go back to the original blues driver. We're only up to scene two, my God. Let's move on. Scene three is the compression plus the blues driver in the clean channel of the amp. Scene four is the clean channel plus the crunch box, which you've already heard, so I'm not going to go there again. It's just there available for you to use immediately if you want it. Scene five is the lead channel of the Lone Star. So these settings are based on illustrations that I saw, I think, even on Messer's own site. I've left the compressor on there, but you can turn it off. Certainly a bit fatter with it on. The next scene is the lead channel with the blues driver. That's a good sound. Scene seven is the same lead channel of the amp, but with the cranked tube driver, which is really thick and kind of almost Dumble-esque. Contrast to the next scene, scene number eight, which is the clean channel with the chorus. Analog stereo chorus. That you can change channels on. Again, something to look at with this one is the compression, because you can choose between the two compression channels and one will be more squeezy than the other. Let's just go back to scene number one for a moment and have a look at this multi-delay. I said before that I'd popped in two channels of the Aurora, which is a version of Robert Keeley's Halo delay. The first channel is the straight-up, unadulterated algorithm, which they call the Halo, or the Aurora, rather. If you go to channel two, it's my tweaked version, and really it's only just a little bit of low-pass filter here.
Mm-hmm.
minute difference, but you know, different enough. I thought I'd pop them both in anyway. So there you go, a bit of AT fun. Hello to Robert and Andy. And if you're wanting to run this on your XFX 3, you'll be needing to run firmware 22 beta 9 or later. That's it. Goodbye. Have fun. Hope you have a great day.